This is my camera comparison test of the new Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra versus the iPhone 15 Pro versus the Google Pixel 8 Pro. Which one is best? Let's find out.
Not only am I going to show you guys daytime and nighttime photo and video comparisons, but we're also going to compare slow motion, action mode, stabilization, AI editing features, and a lot more. I put a ton of work into this one. This video is not sponsored by anyone. This is my authentic review. Jumping right into daytime photos and pushing those insane camera zooms to the max. I honestly find it a little insane that we can be standing so far away from an object like this Huntsville sign and basically read that USA text on that tiny little rocket. Samsung is coming in first place, then Pixel, then iPhone. And I know a lot of you are going to be asking, why are you using the iPhone 15 Pro and not the Max with that new 5X telephoto camera? Well, besides me not owning the Max, because remember I buy these suckers myself, they're dang expensive, plus that Max costs extra $200 and it's way too chunky in hand, I think for myself and most of my friends, we buy the non-Max version, and besides it has the exact same camera besides that tele lens. I still think that this is a fair fight. Comparing field of view, I think the Pixel actually has the widest angle with the ultra wide lens. All three have beautiful dynamic range and colors. Just look at the blues and the greens, they're all rich without being too fake in my opinion. As usual, I'd say the Pixel might lean a tad more flat and natural, while Samsung leans a bit more punchy and vibrant. This is sort of personal taste territory.
Let's compare screen brightness. To my eye, the new S24 definitely is the brightest. Then we've got iPhone and then Pixel, which looks oddly dim. Also, check out reflections. You can see how shiny and reflective that screen is compared to this new anti-reflective coating display.
Front-facing portrait shots and the edge cutouts are getting really good on each of them, even with the wispies in my hair. And notice how the blacks in my jacket and my skin tones, they look pretty different on each. Oddly, on the iPhone, when in portrait mode, it crops in on the field of view, and I prefer the wider angle. To fix this, we switch over to standard photo mode, toggle the zoom out option, snap your photo, then in camera roll, we can turn on the portrait effect. I always love playing with macro mode, and I'm glad to see all three can perform well in this area. The macro details are just so cool. In low light, I popped each of them into night mode, and it looks like Galaxy and Pixel has a better exposure on the ultra wide lens. On the One X, I'd vote it sort of a tie. All three do a fantastic job of noise reduction while keeping a sharp image and details in both the highlights and shadows. As I start to zoom in, they each sort of take turns, but honestly, iPhone's last place for telephoto, then the Pixel is great, and Galaxy is sort of insane. I even ventured outside in the freezing winter night for you guys, and for so many years, as like in the past, the Pixel, well, it excels in this challenge. Its astro shots are just unbelievable. They take forever to capture, like over 4 minutes for just one single shot, but its results are so good. Then I'd actually vote the iPhone in second place with nice looking stars and blue skies. Switching over to my favorite section is the video test, starting with the rear facing camera's 4K 30 ultra wide lens. You should notice that the Pixel looks the widest field of view, which is awesome for landscape and building shots like these. iPhone and second place, they're still pretty good wide angle, but sadly I was kind of disappointed with the S24's ultra wide lens. See, it can't even fit the entire building in frame. I really wish this was wider angle. Now when I pan over to the bright sun and clouds, each side does a nice job of highlight control. Sharpness can be often a weak spot with the ultra wide lens, and I'm happy to report that all of them look pretty good with those finer details. A little jogging stabilization test on the ultra wide. I often use my phone for wannabe action camera shots, and as you can see, none of them are standing out with jaw-dropping stabilization. I'll show you action mode in just a second.
What about a quick audio test? We've got a water fountain going on behind me. This is audio on the Samsung Galaxy S24. This is audio on the iPhone 15 Pro. And this is audio on the Pixel 8 Pro. Which one sounds best?
Jumping to that One X primary, this is always gonna be the better quality lens to shoot on if you can. Now it's very interesting to see how the blues and the greens in the water and skies, they're represented pretty differently on each phone. If you guys have a favorite, definitely let me know down in the comments. It's right below that thumbs up button. Just look at all those teeny tiny details and how crazy sharp all three of them look. It's really cool how far we've come. Autofocus, the dynamic range, you really can't go wrong with any of these.
Quick little battery update. I had them all fully charged. I've been out here shooting for about an hour, and iPhone is in last place, 55%. Galaxy second place at 64%, and Pixel is in the lead at 74%. Very cool.
Now, when it comes to far zoom, obviously it's gonna be pretty similar to the photo results. Since Apple sort of screwed us non-Max users, the 15 Pro is capped at the 3x tele lens. Pixel 8 Pro has that 5x optical zoom, and then S24 Ultra, it sort of wins with the greatest quantity of lenses. It gives us both a 3x and 5x optical zoom. And that 5x is 50 megapixels, which is sweet. I definitely see those results here. iPhone in last place, Pixels in second with far reach but looking a little pixelated, and Galaxy in first with impressive looking clarity even when it's stretched to its limits. I think an underrated feature is the zoom transitions and which one can make the switching of lenses the most seamless when in video recording. In these results, the Pixel looks the most jarring with Samsung in second, and then I'd vote iPhone looking the smoothest. Front facing video, I'm very glad to see all three are looking good quality, nice and sharp in 4K. While I think I might take the Galaxy here as my favorite, it sure has some of that grittiness to it. Some people like it, some people don't. iPhone isn't bad, but it just makes my black jacket look a bit brighter than it should, and it has a little too much red in my face tones. The Pixel is looking pretty nice, but my shiny forehead is reflecting some blown out highlights, and it makes me look a bit more pale than I am, I promise. And check out this torture test of backlit looking straight into the sunshine. The Pixel goes a bit soft with the black jacket, iPhone goes a bit bluish in the jacket, and the Galaxy looks best. I love a good slow motion feature on my smartphone, and I think the Galaxy S24 is gonna win here. They all can capture 120 or 240 FPS, but both the iPhone and Pixel, they're capped at 1080p. The Galaxy has finally removed that sort of janky ultra slow motion mode of short bursts of 960 FPS. It was super low res, and I don't think anyone used it. Now we can finally film at 4K 120 FPS. I hope you guys are watching this video on a large TV or monitor to really see the differences. It's looking much sharper than the others. I tried a quick action mode on all three, and firstly, the Pixel needs to step down to 1080p for its active stabilization mode. The iPhone caps at 2.8K and Galaxy's at 1440p. They each look sort of smoothed out a little bit, but sadly, none of them are near a GoPro, let's say. And speaking of, make sure you guys are subscribed to see my upcoming comparison of maybe the S24 Ultra versus the latest GoPro. Cinematic blur mode is slowly getting better, and these results are pretty interesting. I'd say none of them are good enough that I'd be shooting all my videos in that mode, but it is fascinating to see how they differ with edge detection and then trying to determine which is the primary subject to cut out and then what's to blur in the background. Can't forget a quick low light video test, and while they look mostly similar, check out the carpet on the iPhone, it's pretty smudgy. Switching to the 1X, the white balance and low light exposure is really nice across the board, fairly low noise, which is great. And just for fun, I zoomed way in, pretending let's say you're at a concert at nighttime. Which one do you think is your favorite here? Something I didn't want to miss is what about all those fancy new AI features on the S24 Ultra. It has AI interpolation of frames for fake slow motion shots or just slowing down extra, which is really fun and impressive to play with. That AI generative editing is pretty neat too. With just a few circles and taps, we can easily remove or move objects around in the photos, and then the AI will fill in the gaps. Google Pixel has already had this for a little bit. These images won't win any awards or anything, but my kids and I were having a lot of fun playing with it together. I think that might be one of my biggest takeaways from this massive comparison, is which smartphone is the most fun to shoot with. I think iPhone feels very utility, and not that that's a bad thing, it's just very reliable, it's consistent, it just doesn't push me creatively like the others do. On the S24 Ultra, for example, built straight into the main camera app is a pro photo and pro video mode, with tons of manual controls like mic control or even manual focus with focus peaking. There's this cool dual recording mode. I can capture in 4K two different lenses at the same time, and then I could save those files separately or save them combined into one file with split view or picture in picture. I mean, are you serious, Apple, that you've still capped our time-lapse mode at only 1080p? The Galaxy can set speed, duration, all in 4K. Pixel has a cool action pan or long exposure mode. It also has night sight and time-lapse mode. I could go on and on, but I think you get it, that both the Pixel and the Galaxy, they encourage me to have fun while shooting. They push me to think more creatively by using their powerful capture and editing tools built right in. Sure, we could do some of this with iPhone, but it's all third-party apps and it kind of gets messy. We can't forget to take pricing into account of all this, and honestly, since they all have incredible camera systems, not only can we not go wrong with any of them, and this is great news as we all win, they're all competing against each other and raising that bar collectively. Samsung oddly raised that price this year for the S24 Ultra, and it's dang expensive at $1,300. Now, these other two aren't cheap by any means, but I did find some sweet deals on Amazon with their renewed refurbished program. I'll give you all the links down below, and I'll see you guys in my next video.